Welcome to Celebrating Act Two. Celebrating Act Two is the user manual for the second half of your life.
Hi, I'm Debbie, and I'm back again to talk to you about dating at midlife. And today's word is groundhogging. And groundhogging means somebody who has no ability to change. As in, I wish he'd try a new place, but he keeps groundhogging. And I think so many of our problems as middle-aged singles come from our inability to change. And yet, as our lives have changed and we've become single again, being able to adapt to those changes and be resilient is probably the best thing we can do for ourselves. I mean, let's look at the definition of insanity, which is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting different results. So if you're exactly the same, but you're feeling that you're not making any meaningful connections, it might be time to look at how you might want to change. And I saw this a lot in some of the men that I dated. For example, there was one guy I dated, in fact, he was the subject of one of these longer videos, and he just went on and on about his exes. And I said, okay, I don't want to see you anymore. I'm done. He said, why? And he said, oh, yeah, about my exes. Yeah, I've heard that before. And then I thought maybe he'd broach a new topic, but no, then it was on to some other woman who had done him wrong. Or another fellow I dated just had the most sacrosanct daily routine. You know, these hours he wrote, these hours he went to the gym, this is when he needed to eat. This is when he needed to eat again because he had a very testy metabolism. And if anything would come up to change that schedule, he was just blown away and he had to go get a latte. Just needed that infusion of caffeine and milk. So, you know, I apparently ruined his life because he had to get a lot of lattes while we were hanging out. And you also see, you know, even the ability to change in people's clothing as we get older. I mean, what's a comb over? Except a guy who can't accept that he's going bald and maybe should come up with something else to do with his hair. Or people who wear wearing clothes that are way too small. Let's accept it. Body's changed, buy something new, be comfy. You know, I went through that at one point where all my clothes from when I was newly widowed were too small because I was so thin after my husband died. And then I thought, oh, this is bad. And I went, no, it means you're healthy. The pants are the ones at fault, not you. I even saw this with fellows who would be like, they have to split meals, but all they ate was chicken. This was not an adventurous person. But when my husband died, I wasn't an adventurous person either. I had a very rigid way of living. I had to have my 2 hours a day of exercise, one of cardio, one of weight resistance or yoga. There was my salad, which had to have very particular kinds of dressing. And, you know, life was pretty dull. And I didn't like to do a lot of things like go out to new places or try things. And then I realized if I was going to have any kind of interesting life without my husband, I was going to have to change. I was going to have to join groups. I was going to have to just be a more positive, upbeat person. When I was married, I was a big complainer. And George, wherever you are, I am so sorry. But eventually I did change and I had to keep working with that. You know, my first date with my partner now, and we've been together 4 years, but it was a Memorial Day weekend and he invited me out and he said he was going through a long drive around the beaches in Marin and he mentioned some restaurants he wanted to go to. And my first thought was, God, no, there's going to be traffic. I don't know what parking is like. We're going to these places without reservations on a holiday, probably too much sun. My grandmother would have thought that's a bad idea. And, you know, really we're driving these popular places and beaches on a holiday. And I said, no, just say, oh yes, I'd love to go. And we had a wonderful time. It lasted 12 hours and we're together now and we still talk about that day. So the point I'm making is if you are a middle-aged single and things aren't working for you, it might be because you're too rigid. I know that was my problem. And so you might want to think about the ways you can change to have a better life in the future. I'm Debbie, and I hope that helped.
For more on Celebrating Act Two, visit our webpage, follow us on Facebook, subscribe to us on YouTube, and tell your friends. Celebrating Act 2 is the user manual for the second half of your life.